Coming live from our quarantine houses, this is the Not So Newlywed Game. Good evening and welcome to our homes. I am your host, Mr. Andrews, along with the master of all, Mr. Potts. Tonight, we will be taking a look at some familiar faces and learn a little bit more about these not-so-newlyweds. Up first, we have couple number one, the Propes. These not-so-newlyweds are virtual heroes of these parts. They are cool way before TikTok, Facebook, or MySpace ever were a thing. Their love goes further back than the time of the internet and when we had to look at the Encyclopedia Britannica for information instead of just Googling it. Couple number one, the Propes. Couple number two, the Fishes. These not-so-newlyweds don't have a black and white story as to how they met. They do not like to speak about it often. In fact, they went 2 years of knowing each other before they actually started to talk to each other. That was shortly after their graduation at the Mime Institute. Soon after they tied the knot, as well as cutting the knot and building a small box they could get out of, let's welcome the Fishes. Couple number three, the Best. These not-so-newlyweds are actually semi-newlyweds, so their young puppy love should help them win this game. Welcome, Mr. and Mrs. Best. This not-so-newlywed couple is in their prime time of their marital bliss. They've recently rediscovered that they both still live in the same house after the governor's stay-at-home order was in place. Let's welcome the Grays. Let's welcome couple number five, the Schmitz.
That's a harsh.
Their groom was always speaking so highly of his young bride's cooking, as long as it only uses the microwave and sometimes the toaster oven. Please welcome Mr. and Mrs. Schmidt. Couple number six, the Vanderplug Rinaldi. These not-so-newlyweds that are newlyweds are entering the parental stage. So, if you need to step away during our game, it's probably because the baby or Mr. Vanderplug is crying. Let's welcome Miss Rinaldi and Mr. Vanderplug. The husbands have been secluded in their soundproof rooms. Let's hear from the ladies and see what they have to say. Couple number three, the Best. What is your idea of a dream date?
Probably making dinner at home. Playing some type of competitive game where I win organically, not because I was let to win, and then maybe catching a sunset going to Lake Michigan.
Couple number six, what is your idea of a dream date?
Oh man, anything out of the house without a baby.
Couple number one, what is your worst habit?
Being a little bit messy.
What is your worst habit?
Asking a question even though I already know what answer I want. Like, where do you want to go for dinner? Suggestion, but then I'll say, well, that doesn't sound good. Let's try this.
That's funny.
All right, couple number one. What is the best present you have ever received from your husband?
He gave me a really nice gift. This was even before we were dating. He gave me a Patagonia coat, and that was a nice gift. I think he liked me.
He's trying hard.
But I like that.
Couple number two, what is the best gift that your husband has ever given you?
I am going to be sentimental and say our children.
Oh, that's nice. Aww.
Better than a coat.
I'm kidding, Sarah. I know.
I can't think of anything.
Couple number four, what Disney character are you most like?
I'm going to say Belle because I'm always reading. There you go.
What Disney character are you most like?
And I know Shad doesn't know many Disney characters. So I'm going to go with Jasmine because I think he knows that one.
All right. Couple number four. What is your worst home-cooked meal?
I'm an amazing cook and he eats anything. So nothing.
Couple number six. What is your worst home-cooked meal?
Over quarantine, I tried to get creative and make a lavender goat cheese, and it was disgusting. So I'm going to write that.
Did that ever have a chance to be good?
Yeah, it sounded awesome, but I like put way too much lavender, and it was like sickening, and we couldn't eat it. But I still posted about it on Instagram, like it looked good. So
I like that.
That's a lot of lavender to overpower goat cheese. I love goat cheese.
You say it was awful.
Anything lavender is cool.
Oh, I love lavender.
Hello, chap. Thanks for watching the Nuts and Newlywed game tonight. Our game tonight is sponsored by cheese. Cheese, it's good.
While you guys were away, we asked your wives 5 questions. We will start with the first question with couple number 1. What is your wife's idea of a dream date?
Her hanging out with me. Anything with me.
Ding, ding, ding.
That's spot on.
All right. Couple number 2. What is your wife's idea of a dream date?
Walking around Key West.
Ooh, good answer.
Ooh. Go for a walk.
Go for a walk.
All right. Judge says yes. All right. Couple number 3. What is your wife's idea of a dream date?
It's got a... end with a sunset.
Okay. End with a sunset. Anything else?
That's all I got.
That's all you got. All right, the answer is something, 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 sunset.
I'm feeling really kind in round 1. Really kind.
Couple number 4, what is your wife's idea of a dream date?
Let's see, something outside, probably hiking somewhere new without the kids.
Ding, ding, ding.
Wait, no.
Hike in the woods.
In the
hike
woods. In the woods. Wow. All right, couple number 5, what is your wife's idea of a dream date?
Dream date, not no kids.
Okay. Probably snuggling in and watching a movie. I can tell by the look.
The look.
The look.
No, it was dinner outside and a walk on the beach. Oh.
A couple number 6. What is your wife's idea of a dream date?
Is that us?
Yes.
I would say probably a dinner out without our son, Peter.
No baby.
We'll count it.
That's good.
All right. Question number 2. Back to couple number 1. What is your wife's worst habit?
Well, it's between maybe 2 things for me, but I'm gonna go with she likes to stack stuff in piles and leave it everywhere. Not everywhere, but it's a lot of clutter.
Messy.
Own it.
Couple number 2, what is your wife's worst habit?
Not putting things away. And again, like Benson said, clutter.
Leaving a
2 mess. For 2 on question 2.
No pressure, couple number 3. But what is your wife's worst habit?
I got to say it's putting the hair in the shower on the wall. There's hair all over.
Yeah.
Or it's falling asleep on the couch. One of the 2.
Yeah, that too.
I love that.
That's how we claim things, is with our hair.
Yeah. I do it too.
There's some of those hair balls on our bathroom wall as well.
Yeah, you own everything.
I own nothing. See, nothing. All right, couple number four. What is your wife's worst habit?
Starting things but never finishing them. Always an excuse, a reason to not finish stuff.
And the answer is procrastination. Number five, I know that it's hard to believe that your wife has any worst habits, but we have to come up with one. What is your wife's worst habit?
She's a perfectionist.
Well, I am.
She's
asking a question.
Too good looking.
All right, couple number six. What is your wife's worst habit?
I would say she doesn't put things away well. Like, she will just throw dishes in the dishwasher without like rinsing them, or just throw things in a drawer and like
not folding my laundry.
That's good, right? I would say that's it. That's a point right there.
Count it.
Right, let's go to our next question. What is the best present that you gave your wife?
I'm going to go with a ring that I gave her for her birthday this past September.
What kind of, was it a nice ring?
She liked it. I thought it was nice. She said she liked it.
But not as nice as.
Oh, that was my second guess.
My detector tells us that is a lie.
Her coat. What is the best present that you gave your wife?
I would have to say an anniversary ring.
For what anniversary?
15 and 20. It was a split. 15? We got it in year 18.
Okay. That works. That sounds really nice, but it was not the
best. It was very
present.
Nice. But I said, our kiddo.
Oh.
Well, yeah.
Well, yeah.
All right, couple number three. What is the best present that you gave your wife?
I'm a terrible gift giver. So I'm going to say it's probably her wedding ring, because it was my grandma's ring.
Ding, ding, ding.
Hey,
couple number four, what was the best gift that you gave your wife?
Well, I don't really give a lot of gifts. We don't do birthdays and Christmas for each other. So I think we bought this house on her birthday. She said it was a present for her. I agreed and let that go. I'm going to go with the house. Yeah.
That was good.
Nice. All right, couple number five. No pressure here, but what was the best present that you gave your wife?
Trip to London. I thought it was good.
It was good.
Sherry, all the guys want to know what this was so that they can make one someday, so you better tell them. Their wives are all trying to explain it.
Okay, so one year, a Saturday, one year before Matt and I got married, he gave me a paper chain with a link for every Saturday until we got married, and on every link was a reason why he wanted to marry me.
Wow.
And I still have them. They're in a little box.
So cute.
A trip to London sounds nice.
Well, that was awesome too, yes. I was thinking sentiment, you know.
I almost lost my water.
Oh, don't worry, Schmitz. You'll get a point at some time. I'm feeling it.
I hope. Couple number six. What was the best present that you've ever given your wife?
I think it's slightly more, like I ended up using it more, but I've gotten her the same gift twice now. I got her two different record players.
Oh, I forgot about those. iPhone.
An iPhone.
You got me an iPhone. I'm so surprised. That's like the thing that I was surprised about. Yeah. Sorry.
Question number four. Which Disney character is your wife most like? Couple number one.
I'm going to go with Pluto.
Pluto. I can't believe you got that.
That. You're cheating.
And that's why? That's a cheat.
Why?
Because she's loyal.
Have you talked about this before?
Kind and loyal.
Goofy is also a dog.
Wow.
Is Pluto not kind and loyal?
That's impressive.
It's just shocking that's what she chose and what you thought of. That blows my mind.
And what she said, too.
I know. Wow. See?
You guys have obviously discussed this before.
Which is like a weird thing to talk about.
We talked about the Disney characters before.
Couple number two. Which Disney character is your wife most like? Mm-hmm. Do you know what Disney is?
I know what Disney is. I can't even think of a character right now. And the princess on Aladdin.
That's right.
I have no idea what her name was.
Is that it?
That's it.
That's
right.
Which Disney character is your wife most like?
The girl from Brave.
Oh.
Yeah.
Why?
She's red-haired, very independent.
Okay. Yeah. You're on the right track with the hair, Rapunzel.
Oh, the hair thing, yeah.
Couple number four. What Disney character is your wife most like?
Belle. All she does is read.
Is that right?
Yes.
That's interesting.
Couple number five. What Disney character is your wife most like?
Okay, I'm 98% sure I know this one.
Yes, I hope he gets it right now.
I think she is most like Minnie Mouse.
I'm the board.
Couple number six. What Disney character is your wife most like?
My wife likes Kristen Bell, and she plays Anna of Bell.
That is correct. Our last question is, what is your wife's worst home-cooked meal?
Some kind of soup that she makes?
Her mac and cheese is so bad, it's like soup.
mac and cheese.
Couple number two, what is your wife's worst home-cooked meal?
Well, Mrs. Scoville could attest, because about 2 months ago, she and Mrs. Fish had about a 15-minute conversation about how in the world to make fried chicken, because she struggles. She is an awesome cook. She can't get the fried chicken right. The breading all falls off. I thought she was going to break a window with the frying pan last month.
Fried chicken, I just can't get it right.
Just can't get it right.
Nice job.
That's
impressive. Awesome. I say, careful, I'm the one cooking this quarantine, so.
Couple number three, what is your wife's worst home-cooked meal?
That's awesome.
That is one thing we like to do a lot. We cook a lot together, and so I'm going to say none. She wrote down, she has no bad cooked meals.
Chicken tenders!
Zero bad meals.
Someone might have been there.
Couple number four, what is your wife's worst home cooked meal?
Let's see. If I am home and I'm not at practice and she does cook, nothing's bad because I'll eat anything.
That was it. That's the answer.
Was the answer. Because you will eat anything. Yeah. What is your wife's worst home cooked meal?
Oh, I had a 0.5% of knowing this one. I know that she likes it, and if she's ever cooked it, I probably wouldn't have liked it. I would say chicken pot pie.
Chicken pot pie, no. Tuna noodle casserole. Mm.
Okay, yeah, I agree.
All right, finishing out the first round, couple number six. What is your wife's worst home-cooked meal?
I'm going to say egg drop soup. I don't like it.
I wrote that lavender
goat cheese.
She just made a
That wasn't good. There was too much lavender.
And the truth comes out, he doesn't like your egg drop soup either.
I knew that already.
Just take that off the menu.
There were a lot of options.
Let's take a quick check at our leaderboard before we take a commercial break.
Are your basketball skills not what they used to be? Did you used to have game? Or is it gone like Mr. Andrew's hair? Come check out the Fennville Middle School YouTube page and you can learn from the best. So maybe you can get your game on.
The wives have been secluded in their soundproof room. Let's talk to the husbands and see what they have to say. Couple number one, what is your favorite pizza topping?
Sausage.
Sausage.
Bacon.
Bacon.
Boo.
Which is another form of sausage, just next to that. Question number two, what is your shoe size? Couple number four, what is your shoe size?
10 and a half or 11, depending on if it's a sport or a dress shoe. Mm.
Couple number five, what is your shoe size?
Yeah, 10 and a half, 11, depending on the shoe.
Couple number six, what is your shoe size?
Size 12.
Couple number one, what is your biggest fear?
Hitting a pedestrian while I'm driving.
Are you afraid that they're going to just walk out, or are you afraid that you didn't notice them, or?
I'm just afraid I'm just going to plow them, and that'll be that, and I'll be in jail. Just, you know, it's a terrible thing. Manslaughter, involuntary manslaughter, terrible.
Couple number three, what is your biggest fear?
No judgment here, but werewolves.
Can you say that again? Because you kind of
werewolves.
Werewolves. What are you afraid about?
I don't do scary movies, but I saw Van Helsing one time. I don't like it.
So is that the Breaking Wind movies? Is that werewolves?
Breaking Wind.
That's farting.
Close.
That's what I was thinking. Are you thinking of like Breaking Dawn? Is that
yeah?
The Twilight books.
Paul needs to get out more.
Couple number one. Do you like tea or
coffee all the way?
Couple number five. Tea or coffee?
Coffee.
Couple number six, who is the better driver?
This might be harder for her to guess, but I'm going to specifically say that I am a more skilled driver, but she is a much safer driver. We've talked about it before. I think she can get that, actually, though.
All right. Now's your chance to either run or get your wives back.
Peace for a Moment was brought to you by the letter C, and C is for coffee, and without coffee, there would be no pleasant moments like that. So drink up. Right,
so now we have asked the husbands five hard-hitting questions, and now you will get your opportunity to answer them. The first question was, what is your husband's favorite pizza topping? Couple Ooh. Number one.
Sausage.
And he said.
Sausage. We make a lot of homemade pizza. I make the individual pizzas, and this guy is my sausage guy.
Is he?
Sausage. Got it.
All right, couple number three. What is your husband's favorite pizza topping?
Meat.
Just meat.
The meat,
everything.
All the meat.
Bacon. But especially bacon.
But especially bacon.
Judges?
Did you say bacon before you saw the sign?
No.
Couple number four. Let's keep the streak alive. What is your husband's favorite pizza topping?
Pepperoni.
And the streak continues. Couple number five, what is your husband's favorite pizza topping?
I say meat.
You say meat.
Let's see. Pepperoni.
Pepperoni is correct. Congratulations, you just doubled your score. Couple number six, what is your husband's favorite pizza topping?
I'm going to go with mozzarella cheese.
Mozzarella cheese. Cheese it Got is. It.
Unless it's lavender goat cheese.
Yeah.
Then no.
That's just not good.
What is your husband's shoe size? Couple number one.
Eight.
6'7½.
Oh, good.
Eight is correct. Couple number two. What is your husband's shoe size?
He usually buys his own shoes, but I know that he and Joel are the same size right now, and I just got Joel 10s.
Ten.
Bingo.
That's because Joel stole his shoes the other day, and that's the only reason.
That worked. Good timing.
Yes. Couple number three, what is your husband's shoe size?
9½.
Wow.
That's good.
Wow. What is your husband's shoe size?
Shoes are like a 10½ or 11.
10½ or 11. What is your husband's shoe size?
10½.
Oh no. Oh.
10½, 11.
We'll give it to him. They're the feel good story right now, trying to move out of last place.
Couple number six. What is your husband's shoe size?
Size 12.
Wow. Size 12. Here. Couple number one. What is your husband's biggest fear?
That he'll hit a bicyclist in the car.
Pedestrian.
That is amazing.
That is impressive. Well, hey, Probst, what kind of car do you drive?
We have a van and we have just a sedan.
Like color, make, model. I want to make sure to get
Look out.
VIN number, everything. Mm. Couple number two, what is your husband's biggest fear?
We actually talk about this because I think his biggest fear is the same as mine. Something bad would happen with the family, like something with the kids or bad would happen.
That is correct. Just avoid probes driving.
That's what you get on a bike and you're good.
Yeah.
Don't be a pedestrian, apparently, to this point.
Right. Couple number three. What is your husband's biggest fear?
Balding, getting old? I don't know.
Balding. Is it balding? Couple number four. What is your husband's biggest fear?
He probably said something cheesy, like about being a dad, but the real answer is heights. He's afraid of heights.
What? And the answer is the cheese.
That was so hard for me to listen to, knowing that you knew the right answer, but you didn't trust your instincts.
Right.
Couple number five, what is your husband's biggest fear?
Someone standing and staring at him or standing over him when he's sleeping.
Oh. Not my biggest fear, but it's a fear.
For those sharks, especially the freshwater kind.
Right.
Couple number six, what is your husband's biggest fear?
I'm going to go with me dying and him having to take care of Peter by himself.
Oh. No, I might not get it, but that's a close second. Something bad happening to Peter.
Well, that is really bad.
right ballpark.
No oh, problem. Dang it.
Does your husband like tea or coffee?
That's pretty easy.
Coffee
he
master.
He loves coffee, and he likes tea, but he loves coffee. Coffee.
Coffee. Couple number two, coffee or tea?
Coffee. Black.
Couple number three, tea or coffee?
Coffee.
Couple number four, tea or coffee?
Definitely not coffee. McDonald's sweet tea?
Come on, that's the exact.
And I think he specifically did say
McDonald's
sweet tea. Only tea he drinks.
He did.
That is impressive. Couple number five, tea or coffee?
Coffee.
Coffee. Couple number six, tea or coffee?
Just within the last like year or so, we started drinking coffee, so I'm going to guess coffee.
Coffee. Who is the better driver? Couple number one.
I think I am. I hope.
We all
based on...
Sarah.
200%.
Oh, good.
All right. Team number two, who is the better driver?
Not me. Mister. Mister.
All right. Couple number three, who is the better driver?
We discuss this often and we disagree, but I know he thinks he's the better driver.
So, are you admitting right here, right now, in front of all of the people watching this, that he is the better driver?
He drives us together more often. How about that?
That is a great way to escape the answer to the question. And you are correct. He is the better driver.
Diplomacy.
Or at least he thinks so. Couple number four. Who is the better driver?
He doesn't let me drive much. So he said he is. Yeah, he's the better driver.
All right. right. Couple number five, who is the better driver?
He thinks it's him.
Is that your answer?
That's my answer.
Is that your final answer?
I'm better, but he'll say him.
All right. And last but certainly not least, couple number six.
Okay.
Who is the better driver?
This is like a point of contention because I am more safe, but he probably thinks he's better because he can like switch lanes really well without looking and like parallel park all impressive. So I mean,
did you say switch lanes without looking?
Yeah. He's skilled.
I check my mirrors.
I have to go like, ah! Like the whole car moves. But he probably put himself because he thinks he's more skilled, which he thinks is more important. But safety is more important.
This is a very, I feel like she's got.
I'm giving you that because that was.
We talk about this a lot.
That's impressive.
That was good.
That was verbatim what John said.
And let's take a quick look at our updated scoreboard before we get into our final question. Hi, this is Mr. Andrews with a most special announcement. Have you ever fallen and not been able to get up? Have you just laid on the floor hoping for someone or something to come by and help you? I have a new product for you that will keep you upright and surely will keep those pesky people away. Just pick up your phone right now and dial 555-4155 for your own personal bubble. That's 555-4155. For your own personal bubble that will always get you back up again. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. So here is the question that we are looking for, and your points that you wagered will either be added or subtracted from your total score that you ended with. So here is the question. What was your spouse's first car?
The Toyota MR2.
Jeez, that's specific. Wow.
And that is correct. Mm-hmm. Couple number two, what was your spouse's first car?
The car that her dad felt safe for her driving, a big boat Crown Vic.
Oh, yeah. What was your spouse's first car?
A truck.
Can you be more specific?
A Chevy truck?
A Chevy truck.
I don't know.
Ford. 50. Couple number four, what was your husband's or your spouse's first vehicle?
The Aries. Dodge K car. It was gray. He said he got over 80.
Dodge Aries K car. Couple number five. What was your spouse's first vehicle?
Little Datsun 280Z or 380Z.
Nope. That was like my fourth car.
And let's finish it up with team number six. What was your spouse's first vehicle?
Okay, I'm horrible at car names. I know it was a convertible and it was green and I think it was like before the 2000s, so like 90s-ish.
Man, you're so close.
I don't know any car names. It's a convertible.
It's a 97 Sebring convertible in green.
Oh!
Nice.
I'm gonna let that to the judge.
Come on, Brett.
All right. So before we get to our final scores and the grand prize of what you get to win, I would like to thank you all so much for joining us and taking part in this fun activity and boosting our morale as a staff, as well as the morale of the students in our community to see us having some fun together. So without further ado, let's take a look at our leaderboard with our final scores. Coming in last place, we have a three-way tie.
If it's the Schmitz, they should take that considering how they started.
Yeah. History loves company.
So in last place, tied with zero, that is 0 points, is the best, the Schmitz and Vanderplug and Rinaldi. Coming up in second place from the top and second place from the bottom, we have a two-way tie. A two-way tie. And that is the Propes and the Grays with 16 points. So that means in first place with a grand total of 18 points, Mr. and Mrs. Fish. Mr. and Mrs. Fish, for the grand prize, what you get is you get a three-week stay at your house. All expenses paid by you. Congratulations. You can use your backyard, front yard, side yard, basement, whatever it is, and stay there for the next 3 weeks. So congratulations on that grand prize, as well as, most importantly, bragging rights for being crowned the Not So Newlywed Game Champions.